Welcome friends to my channel State and Repeat, where we have started a lecture series on sample survey. This is the 14th part of the series, and in this part we shall discuss about snowball sampling. Okay, so friends, we have already discussed about all the sampling technique like simple random sampling, stratified random sampling, systematic sampling, quota sampling, cluster sampling, and two-stage sampling, multi-stage sampling. Okay, so we have already discussed about all these techniques. Okay, now at the end of the series I am going to discuss about snowball sampling. So if people are able to understand that in which scenario or in which situation snowball sampling technique is used to draw sample from the population, okay, and why all the other sampling technique are not supposed to use to draw sample from the population in such situation, okay. So what is snowball sampling? Actually, the snowball sampling is a non-probabilistic sampling, okay. It is not a probability sampling. Here we are not going to use any such random technique to draw sample from the population, okay. This sampling technique is also known as chain referral sampling technique. So why it is known as chain referral sampling technique, you will understand when you understand the process of the technique, okay. So basically snowball sampling has three types. First one is linear snowball sampling, second one is exponential non-discriminative sampling, and third one is exponential discriminative sampling, okay. So in this sampling technique, what you do, or you can say how we can collect the data by using this sampling technique, let's understand this with the help of these pictures, okay. So mainly snowball sampling is used in such a place where you want to collect the data for certain events, okay, and these events are very rare among the population, okay. And if you want to collect the data of such types, then using the sampling techniques like simple random sampling, stratified random sampling, multi-stage sampling, and all other sampling techniques are become costlier, okay, because the event for which you are going to collect the data is very rare among the population. That's why this type of sampling technique, whatever we discussed earlier in our series, this become very costlier, okay. And we know that one of the principles of the sample survey is to minimize our cost to draw sample from the population as much as we can, okay. So this is one of our principle, okay. So based on this principle, we are not going to collect the sample from the population in such cases where we want to collect the data for a particular event which is very rare among the population. So in this type of cases we generally use snowball sampling, okay. So in this snowball sampling, I've already told you that there are three types, okay. So in the first type, that is, this type is called linear snowball sampling, this one is called exponential non-discriminative snowball sampling, and this one is called exponential discriminative sampling, okay. So understand this. Suppose for example, from our sources of information we come to know about a person who have experienced that particular event in his or her life. If we get a information of a person like that, in that case what we'll do, we just go to that person and collect information from him, okay. And it is a natural phenomenon that a person having a particular event in his or her life which is very rare among the population. So in that case, what the person actually do, he try to deal with that, and he also try to search for other person who also have that type of particular event in their life, so that he can take experiences from them and then use that experience in his life also, okay, to tackle that incident. If you get information about a person like that, then we will go to that person and then collect the information from that person, and it may happen that that person also have some information about some other person who also have experienced that type of incident in their life, okay. So in this way, first you go to the person which you know about from our sources, okay, and after that, after going to that person inform us about another person, okay. Then what we'll do, we'll go to the other person, okay, and then after going to the second person, it may happen that the second person also inform about the other person who have also experienced this, such type of incident in his or her life, okay. So in this way we collect information from one by one, okay? So if we go in this way, that means first you go to one person and that one person gives the information of the other person, okay? And after getting the information about the other person from the first one, we go and collect information from him or her. And after collecting information from that person, he also recommended another person. So we again go to that person which is recommended by the previous one, okay? And in this way, we'll collect our data from person to person, and we continue this process until whatever sample size is decided for our study, okay? As soon as we complete our sample size, that time we will stop and then sum up all our information and analyze for the study, okay? So here you can see that from one person we are getting the information of the other person, okay? And from that person we are getting the information of the other person. So it becomes a chain, okay? Isn't it? It becomes a chain. That's why this sampling technique is also known as chain referral sampling technique, because you can simply see that a chain is developed in the process, okay? That's why this is also called chain referral sampling technique, okay? And if it happens that the information of the first person we get from our source of information, and after getting the information of the one person, if the person gives the information of only one person and again the second person gives the information of only one person, and if it is going like that, that means all the people are giving the information of one and only one person, then this snowball sampling is called linear snowball sampling technique, okay? Now let's understand what is exponential non-discriminative snowball sampling, okay? So from this word exponential, you can understand that here the chain is expanded exponentially, okay? And here what happened? The chain is expanded linearly, okay? So exponential then non-discriminative. What is non-discriminative? That means the chain is expanded exponentially and it is not diminishing, okay? It is not decreasing, it is increasing, okay? Chain by chain it is increasing. How? So again, we get the information of the first person from the source of our information, okay? Having that particular characteristic or particular event in his or her life. Whatever information we want to collect, okay? So, suppose for example, this is the person, okay? Now, we go to that person for collecting our information from him, okay? And then, after going to that person inform us about another two person which have the same characteristic in their life, okay? So we get the information of other two person. So due to fulfill our objective of the study, we go to the other two person which is informed by this person, okay? So we go to the other two person, and after visiting this person also gives the information of other two person having the same incident in their life, okay? And again, when you go to the next person, this person also inform us about other two person, okay? In this way, you can see that the chain is expanded, okay? From one, we get the information of other two. So in this stage, we get the information of three person, okay? And from these two persons, we get the information of this person. That means in this step, how many information we have gathered? We have gathered the information of seven person, okay? And after getting the information of this person from these persons, we again go to these persons to collect information, okay? And we will continue this process until we have completed our sample size for our study, okay? So after going to all these persons, they also inform us about another person. Someone give information of another three person, and someone gives information of another one person, like that, okay? And we will continue this process until we get our sample size for the study, okay? So in this process, you can see that our chain is expanded, okay? It is expanded exponentially, okay? It is expanding very fast. So in the first step, we have only one information, and then in the second step, we have three information. In the third step, we can have seven information, and it is non-discriminative. That means from chain by chain, we are getting more and more information from the objects of our study, okay? So this type of snowball sampling is known as exponential non-discriminative snowball sampling. Okay, so you understand this term non-discriminative in a better way when we discuss this technique. Okay, exponential discriminative sampling. So what is exponential discriminative sampling? So here what you do, first step is the same, that means get the information about a person from the source of our information and we go to that person for collecting the data regarding that particular topic or event for which we want to collect our information. Okay, and after going to that person, this person inform us about the other three person. Okay, that means he knows about the other three persons who also have that particular event in their life. Okay, so in the exponential non-discriminative snowball sampling, we can see that the first person also gives the information of multiple objects, that means more than one objects. Okay, so here also the first gives the information of multiple objects, that means more than one objects, but here we are not going to collect the information from all the three objects which he has informed to us. Okay, this person gives the information of other three persons, but here we just collect the data from one person among the three persons. Okay, that means we have the information of three persons from that object. Okay, from this person, but we are not going to collect the data from all three persons. We collect the data from only one person among the three persons. Okay, so other two persons are not included in our sample. Okay, again after going to that person, this person also, suppose for example, gives the information of other three persons. Okay, but here also we are not going to collect the data from all the three persons which he informed to us. We just collect the information from one person and the rest will not be included in our sample. Okay, because we are going to collect the data from only one person among the three person. Okay, so in this way we go to that person and again we collect information from him, and again suppose he gave the information of other three person or two person, but we are not going to collect the information of the all person which he informed to us. We just collect information from one person among the all which he informed to us. Okay, so in this way we continue our process until the same thing. When our sample size is completed, in that case we will stop our sampling. Okay, and sum up all this information to analyze our data. Okay, so here you can see that the first person gives the information of multiple objects, but we are considering only one object. Okay, again after going to the second person, he also gives the information of multiple objects, but we consider only one object. Okay, so rest of the objects are not considered in our study, only one objects are considered in our study. So here the chain is expanded exponentially. Though the chain is expanded exponentially, but it is discriminative. It is decreasing because we are not considering the information of all the gathered information, all the objects, whichever we get information from the earlier person. Okay, so that's why though the chain is expanded exponentially, but it is discriminative in nature. Okay, that's why it is called exponential discriminative snowball sampling. So now I think you can understand that what is the difference between exponential non-discriminative snowball sampling and exponential discriminative sampling. Okay, so these are the ways for collecting information for our sample, where we want to collect the data for a particular event and that particular event is very rare among the population. Okay, and if we use the other sampling technique like simple random sampling, stratified random sampling, it becomes very costlier to draw a sample like that. Okay, so suppose for example we want to collect the data about the recovery rate of the person having snake bite in their life. Okay, the incident itself, the person having snake bite in their life, is also not very common in your day-to-day life. Okay, so in this type of situation, we suppose to do snowball sampling to collect our information. Okay, so if we want to collect the data for this type of events, in this type of situations, it is meaningless to collect the information by using the technique of simple random sampling, stratified random sampling, or another sampling technique. Okay, because it is a just wastage of time. So friends, now I think that snowball sampling is very clear to you, and you can understand that in which situation we can use snowball sampling and why we are not going to use the other sampling technique in this type of situation. Okay, so if it is so, then please like, share and subscribe my channel, and please make comment. Okay, so thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you.